Welcome to the Accounts Payable section of our course. Now you may well ask, what is Accounts Payable? Basically, Accounts Payable is keeping records of vendors and the vendor transactions. If you look a little deeper, it really means keeping track of what you owe. Keeping records of what you owe to the vendors really counts as the Accounts Payable bookkeeper's job. We all know that accounts payable is an account in the chart of accounts. And accounts payable represents all the money that's owed to all the vendors together. For example, if you owe to Verizon $200 and you owe to UPS $400 and you owe to Staples $600, that means the general ledger account accounts payable should equal $1,200, the total money owed to all vendors. It would therefore make sense that we have to keep records of each individual vendor and the balance that we owe them. It would also make sense that anytime any one particular vendor's balance increases from a transaction, the total accounts payable in the chart of accounts will go up by the same amount. And of course, anytime you have a transaction where any vendor's balance decreases, that means that accounts payable in the chart of accounts and the general ledger will go down by the same amount. If you already did the customer and accounts receivable section and you looked at the beginning 9 or 10 videos that introduced you to this course, then you should be familiar with the vendor center. You will use the vendor center to put the vendors on the list. Now, we already have on the list Verizon, Staples, and UPS from the previous banking section as well as other previous sections. What you need to add to the list for the accounts payable section is vendor Con Edison, who gives us electricity, and vendor Rex Repair, who fixes Holden's equipment. Your first assignment here in the vendor accounts payable section will be to add these two new vendors to the list and edit the existing vendors to put in the addresses. Here are the addresses that we will use. Of course, they are only for example. We will put in these addresses just so we have a little practice with the vendor center to begin our accounts payable part of the course. So you can pause the video in this position or rewind the video to this position if you have trouble remembering what the address is as you put it in. But we will use the vendor center in QuickBooks to add these two vendors with their address and put in these addresses, and that will conclude our first video. As you might remember, to open the vendor center, click Vendor, Vendor Center. Notice here are all the names on the vendor list. Even though Capital One Credit Card is not a vendor, their name still goes on the vendor list because they're someone whom we pay. Now, remember, we add a new vendor by clicking New Vendor and then New Vendor. Okay, here's the new vendor window, and of course we will put Con Edison. Okay, now of course the company name should be the same. This is the name for our records. This is the name that will print on any bill or statement or letter that we send to the vendor. And of course their address is down here. Take a quick peek back at the PowerPoint. Their address is 1010 Winds Lane, Flushing, New York. So we go 1010 Winds Lane, Flushing, New York. And the zip code you might not be able to see, but it's 44444. Click OK, and now we have Con Edison on the list. Notice if we choose Staples, we can see some past transactions for Staples here in the Transactions tab. If we click UPS, we can see some past transactions with UPS here in the Transactions tab. And you can explore and experiment with these other tabs on your own time as they are easy and convenient to work with. Let's add the next vendor. The next vendor is Rex Repair 2020 Vision Lane. So the name in our records, as well as the company name, should be the same. And then of course down here is the address on the set. Click here, hit enter, 2020 Vision Lane. Okay, and we'll take a look. It's Bronx, New York, 55555. Bronx, New York, 55555. Click OK, and now we added these two vendors. That's why when we click on them, we don't see transactions, but when we click on the existing vendors, we see a list of all the transactions for that vendor. And again, you could sort and experiment with the controls here on your own time. Now let's give Verizon the address 1616 Mockingbird Lane. So we double click Verizon, and of course we'll put that as the company name, and we'll give the address 1616 Mockingbird Lane. Okay. Let's find out what state that is. New York, New York, a town so nice they named it twice. And you can see here we're in the Edit Vendor window. Click OK. Same thing with UPS. If you double click, you're not in the New Vendor window, you're in the Edit Vendor window. You can copy the name in our records to the official company name. When you push Tab, that becomes the first line of the address. Hit Enter, and we'll go with 742 Evergreen Terrace, Hometown, New Jersey. 742 Hometown, New Jersey. 33333. And of course, there's only one vendor left, and that's Staples. Make sure you can copy the name in our records to the official company name. Push Tab and it becomes the first line of the address. Hit Enter. And then of course, 123 Sesame Street, Brooklyn, New York. That makes sense. And of course, the zip code is 22222. And now our vendors are set up and ready to go. And now we can make vendor transactions, enter, and pay bills.